In today's video, we're going to be talking about the premiums on silver and what I personally think it's going to take for us to begin seeing the premiums start to drop. And I'm also doing a giveaway in the VIP club right now. Join before May 1st to automatically get entered. All you have to do is simply become a VIP club member. That's it. That's all. Link in the description. What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video. Hope you're doing well, feeling great, and staying safe. It's a great day to have a great day. Today, I wanted to talk about silver and whether or not I personally believe we're going to see the premiums begin to drop down lower in the future. We're going to get into it, but really quick, just in case you're new, make sure to subscribe for daily videos. Also, subscribe to my second channel, which is my backup channel for exclusive weekly content. Brand new video over there. Go check it out. The link will be in the description. And if you want to get some DYDSS merchandise to help support the channel, I would really, really, really appreciate it. Any and all merchandise can be found by clicking the first link in the description section down below. Thank you in advance. It's more than appreciated. But today is Monday, April 26th, 2021. It's currently 59 degrees outside and it's blaring hot because it's nice and sunny. I love it out here. So in case you hear any birds chirping or cars driving past, it's because once again, filming today's video outside. Why be inside when you can be outside? So today I also wanted to very quickly talk about the spot price of silver and also the spot price of gold. Now silver, as I'm recording the video, is sitting at $26.08, which means it's up a whole whopping 11 pennies. Wow.
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 And gold is $1,778.90, which means it's up $2. But I wanted to talk about premiums today. I didn't really want to talk about the spot price. I want to talk about the premiums, these hefty, obnoxious, through-the-roof premiums that have been rocking us for the last 13 months. So I'm not going to sit here and pretend that I have inside information. I'm not going to sit here and act like a false prophet and tell you if and when something specific is going to happen. I just have a couple of ideas of things that could lead to the premiums beginning to drop back down. Now, right at the start of the video, I just want to say that I don't think the premiums are going to drop for a very, very long time. But several years in the future, I think a couple of different things could lead to the premiums actually beginning to drop. Now, this all started last year, and I don't need to reiterate the last 13 months because, well, we know. We know what took place. We know what it resulted in terms of spot price crashing and then going up and the premiums going through the roof. We know all that. But at the very beginning, March of 2020, when all of this craziness first got started, I remember taking 3 months off of stacking, and it had nothing to do with the premiums, although I wasn't all that enthusiastic about paying $10, $15 over spot to begin with. The reason I stopped stacking for 3 months was because at the very beginning, I didn't know what was going to happen. I didn't know what was fully going on. No one knew all of the details. Quite honestly, I don't think even today anybody has all of the details. All I knew was that there was a lot of craziness going on. All I know is that a lot of things were shutting down, and all I knew was that my income could be on the line. So I didn't want to be converting my dollars into anything. I didn't want to be spending my dollars on anything. I didn't want to be trading my dollar bills for anything. I wanted to cling to my dollar bills just in case, just to get a feel for what was really going on, and I just wanted to play it safe, so that's just the decision that I made. And during those 3 months, I was focusing a little bit more on prepping. Now, I already had the Berkey water purification system, I already had the Nesco food dehydrator, and later that year I ended up getting the Jackery Explorer 500 portable power station and the Solo Stove campfire portable fire pit and cooking stove. Those four products will be linked in the description, Amazon affiliate links in case anybody wants to read a little bit about them or get one for yourself. But those were some ideas, those were some products, those were some things that I was getting my hands on to help me prepare. Multifaceted preparation system. But after those 3 months, I saw that the premiums were still pretty high. I saw that the spot price was making a little bit of a comeback, because initially it fell from $18 down to about $12. 3 months later, silver had climbed up to $13, $14, maybe $15, $16. It was on its way back up. But the premiums were not on their way back down. In fact, the premiums climbed up higher as spot price would climb up higher. And I thought that this was particularly interesting, especially with all of the comments that I would receive from so many different people, some who had just got started stacking, some who had been stacking for years, potentially decades, people in the live chat during my live streams, which, by the way, I used to do my live streams here on YouTube. Now I do them in the VIP club, link in the description if you want to join. But during all of these live streams from people who were in the live chat or when I was posting videos and they would be in the comments, they were telling me that they were paying $15 over spot. And I remember thinking to myself, good Lord, spot price is about $15. They're not paying a premium. They're paying spot price on top of spot price for each individual troy ounce of silver, primarily the Silver Eagle. I know the generic silver rounds and even the Maple Leafs and Philharmonics and whatnot had a little bit lower of a premium. But silver in general, the premiums went through the roof, especially on Silver Eagles, which is most people's favorite pure silver 1 troy ounce coin to stack. But with the massive amount of people telling me that they were paying such a crazy high premium just to simply get their hands on silver, it became evident that there was a massive, massive wave of a crazy high stacking demand. So my mind automatically went to, okay, I don't think these premiums are coming down anytime soon, because business is business, and if customers are willing to pay, the business is able to charge. That's just the way it works. That's supply and demand. And as unfortunate and frustrating as it was for me, and probably each and every one of you out there, in a weird way, you gotta appreciate the fact that there's not a government entity hovering over the precious metal dealing websites or the coin shops saying that you're not allowed to charge what you want to charge. You have to charge what we're telling you you're allowed to charge. So as brutal as it was, I can say that I can appreciate that right there. But moving forward, after those 3 months had gone by, and then another 3 months had gone by, we were 6 months into the 14-day lockdown, and then we were 9 months into the 14-day lockdown, then we were 12 months into the 14-day lockdown, and now we're going on 14 months in this 14-day lockdown, and the premiums are still pretty hefty. I have noticed, I will say, that I have seen the premiums drop a little bit. Not by a whole lot. Barely noticeable, but someone like me, who keeps all of my tabs open all the time, I got Atmex, JM Bullion, SD, Provident Metals, Modern Coin Mod, I got all the precious metal dealing websites, all different tabs open at all times, and I'm constantly bouncing back and forth between all of them, just checking to see what's going on, what the spot price is, obviously, what the premiums are going for on this particular coin or this particular round or this particular bar on this particular site versus that site over there. That's what I've been doing for, honestly, almost 3.5 years, not just since everything got crazy. This is what I've been doing since I got started stacking in the first place in late 2017. And everything that we saw happen in 2020 and everything that we saw happen in almost the first half of 2021, the stacking demand is still up high. And I think that's because there's still a lot of massive economic uncertainty right now. I think right now there's a lot of people who are afraid. Silver and gold, as I said in a video that I posted just a couple of days ago about how the precious metals react to bad news, silver and gold, they do very, very well when people are afraid, when people are going through financial hardships, when the country, or in this case, the entire planet, is going through economic turmoil, when a lot of people are struggling, when people are fearful that taxes are going to go up, when people are hesitant to invest in this or invest in that, or if they know that inflation is right around the corner, or if they don't know if their paycheck is gonna get taken away from them. All of this economic uncertainty and financial anxiety, for lack of better verbiage, drives a lot of people to the silver and gold. And this large-scale, uneasy feeling has not yet subsided. But as we slowly but surely get back on track, I'm talking about later in 2021, into 2022 and 2023, because obviously it's not an overnight bing, bang, boom, snap your finger, problem solved. It's not an overnight thing. It's been 13 and a half months already. But as we slowly but surely get back on track, as we see more reopenings, as we see fear subside, as we see more people get back to work, unemployment goes down, employment goes up, spending goes up, investing goes up, small businesses begin to thrive again, and things get back on track. I think the wave of stacking demand will drop. I think less people are going to be focused on the silver and the gold. And I think more people are going to be focusing on business, stocks, and real estate. But for the people like us who are stacking for long-term wealth preservation purposes, and we're stacking the silver and gold coins, rounds, and bars simply because we like it, we enjoy it, it's fun to talk about, and we're enthusiastic. I think a lot of us are driven to the silver and gold more because we like it rather than because we're afraid not to be involved. I enjoy the silver and the gold. I like being here. I am not here because I'm afraid not to be here. But the people who dove in out of fear and they're clinging on exclusively because they're afraid, when they begin to let go, I have no idea how long it's going to take. But when it does happen, I think that's when we can potentially expect to see the premiums lower a little bit, or begin to lower, get the ball rolling a little bit, because when that stacking demand goes down and all these massive online precious metal dealing websites see that they're getting less orders and more of their customers are beginning to potentially shop elsewhere or stop shopping for precious metals altogether, I think that's when we can probably begin to see the premiums dropping back down to a somewhat slightly more reasonable fiat dollar bill price tag. Now, I could be completely wrong. This entire video is just really just me thinking out loud, to be honest with you. And it's also just my opinion. I'm not a financial advisor, so nothing on this channel is financial advice. Do your own research, form your own opinions, make your own decisions based off of your conclusions, not mine. And once again, I do not have inside information. I'm not a psychic, nor am I a false prophet, so I'm not going to guarantee or promise anything. I wish that I could, but at the end of the day, I have no idea. I'm just thinking out loud. These are just some of my assumptions and expectations. But I want you guys to head on down to the comments and let me know. Do you think we're going to see the premiums on silver begin to lower? And I'm not talking about over the next couple of weeks or the next couple of months. I'm talking about potentially a year, year and a half down the road, as we slightly get back on track, as more people are working, more people are spending, more people are buying homes, buying new cars, going on vacation, and the obsessive consumption, obsessive consumerism comes back, and people begin to not be so afraid financially. Their income goes back to being in somewhat of a state of stability, and people are just in general not nearly as afraid as they were. Do you think we're going to begin to see the premiums drop back down a little bit? Not back down to $1, $2 over spot. I think those days are long gone. But I'm talking about just dropping down by a little bit, dropping down by $1 or so, maybe $2, $3. Head on down to the comments and let me know anything and everything related to today's video topic, and if you think the premiums are going to drop back down on the beautiful white precious metal. And if anybody's interested in joining the Precious Metals VIP Club, it's where I can do things on my own terms, not on YouTube's terms, my terms. I'm hosting privately held live streams. They're smaller and easier to manage. Exclusive VIP-only adventure vlogs. I'm also doing giveaways. I have one going on right now. Join the VIP Club before May 1st to automatically get entered. It's all you have to do. Simply become a VIP Club member. I'm also doing discounts, personalized promo codes, shout-outs, deal alerts when silver and gold is on sale on a variety of different websites. And, of course, you can watch all of my videos early and commercial-free. Come join the Precious Metals VIP Club. It'll be the first link in the description. You're invited. I'd be happy to have you. And if you guys enjoyed today's video, please hit that like button. If you guys like me, make sure to hit that subscribe button like a Karen hits a bus window. Or you can hit the subscribe button like Masvidal hit the canvas the other night. Also subscribe to my second channel, which is my backup channel for exclusive weekly content. Bunch of brand new videos over there. Just posted one about how tech stocks could be in trouble. Other ones about silver, other ones about gold, other ones about stocks, even one about the credit card crackdown, and a bunch of others. Go check them out. The link will be in the description. Trying really hard to hit 3,000 subscribers. We just hit 2,000, and I appreciate that. And if you want to help support the channel in the biggest possible way, please consider getting yourself some DYDSS merchandise. Of course, we have some precious metal themed t-shirts and hoodies, which are up for grabs, along with a ton of other products. T-shirts, hoodies, even stickers, many of which are raising funds and awareness for different charity organizations, such as the recently released Crackin' Stackin' t-shirt, hoodie, sticker, and coffee mug, inspired by the beautiful 2-ounce silver Crackin' coin, which, by the way, is helping us raise a little bit of funds and awareness for ocean cleanup charity organizations at no additional cost to you. It comes out of my pocket, not yours. And, of course, the brand new DYDSS Karen Free Zone t-shirt, hoodie, sticker, and coffee mug.
My name is not Karen.
Any and all merchandise can be found by clicking the first link in the description section down below. Thank you in advance. It's more than appreciated. And I want you guys to head on down to the comments and let me know, once again, what do you think it would take for these massive online precious metal dealing websites to begin dropping their premiums a little bit? Do you think it would need to be the economy getting back on track and everything returning to somewhat of a state of normality? That way it probably triggers the stacking demand to drop a little bit, and all of a sudden, with there being a smaller demand, maybe the premiums can begin getting knocked down a little bit. What do you think it's going to take, if it's going to happen at all? Head on down to the comments and let me know anything and everything related to today's video topic. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you tomorrow, and remember, don't you dare stop smiling. Peace. Wow.
Wow. Wow.